Dr. Keith Miller, and I'm here to give a demonstration to help better understand some of the basic concepts of seismic waves. Seismic waves are vibrations generated in the Earth's interior that carry energy away from the focus of an earthquake, from the initial rupture of an earthquake on a fault line, to carry that energy away towards the surface where we experience that as a ground shaking that we call an earthquake. So this demonstration will look in particular at a particular category of seismic waves called body waves. Body waves are those seismic waves or those vibrations that travel through the Earth's interior as opposed to along the surface of the Earth, which we call surface waves. And there are two basic types of body waves. These are called P waves and S waves. And our objective in this demonstration is to show some of the distinctive characteristics of P and S waves. All right, what I'd like you to do, I have a group of courageous student volunteers who are going to help me do this demonstration. So what I'd like you to do is line up here at a line. And let's see here. Why don't you come here to this end? Cool. What I want you to do is I want you to all turn and face that direction. There, right? Now, what I want you to do is put your hands out in front of you, grab the shoulders of the person in front of you, and lock your elbows. Keep them straight, not just lock them straight, okay? Firmly gripping the person in front of you, okay? Now, what these students represent is individual atoms in a solid, okay? So their connection, their gripping each other, represents the chemical bonds that hold atoms rigidly in position relative to each other. Okay? So they're holding the person in front of them, gripping them tightly. So this is an illustration of the chemical bonds in a solid that are holding the atoms in a rigid position. Okay? Yeah, so everyone's in position, everyone has their elbows nice and locked, right? Okay? So for this first demonstration I'm going to give is for a P wave. P waves are compressional waves. That is the motion of the molecules in the solid as a seismic wave passes through is in the same direction as the wave propagates through the material. Okay? So the motion, the vibrational motion of the atoms is in the same direction as the wave travels. So what you've seen is made an impact here, so that would be like the initial rupture of the earthquake fault line. And that energy, we're talking about the transfer of energy, that energy is being transferred from atom to atom by way of the chemical bonds that hold them rigidly in position. Okay? Now, I want you to do something else, which is now turn to face this direction. All right. And now instead of putting your arms on each other's shoulders, put your elbows out kind of like on a little teapot and interlock. Okay? So again, you want to be firmly locked together. And we'll step forward a little bit here. That way. Okay, cool. Perfect. Okay. We're still doing we're still doing a solid in which the atoms are locked together. Now the locking of arms is illustrative of the chemical bonds holding them together. But instead of doing a P wave, we're now going to do an S wave. Okay? Now in an S wave, the motion, the vibrational motion of the atoms is actually perpendicular to their direction of propagation through the material. So now the atoms, the material in the vibrations, actually moving at right angles to the direction that the waves are traveling down the line. Okay? Everyone all nicely locked together? Okay?
Just do it quick.
Okay? Notice I've been able to send the energy down the line. This is a solid. Everyone's locked together, atoms are locked together in a solid. And again, I can transfer that energy. In this case, it's a shearing energy, a shearing movement. But I can transfer it through the material if it's a solid. Okay. Now we're going to do something different, showing a different type of material. And I want you to, again, stand back to back. Not back to back, front to back, sorry. Facing that direction. And put your arms out in front, like you did before. Except in this case, don't grab the person in front of you, so back up a little bit, so that there's maybe, an inch or so between you and the person in front, okay? Everything was supposed to be still in the lock of your arms region, okay? But you're not grasping on to the person in front, okay? Okay, now this is, instead of being a solid, what we're trying to illustrate here is a liquid, okay? So we have the atoms that are still fairly close to each other, but they're free to move relative to each other. They're not held together rigidly by chemical bonds. So they're actually not actually connected to each other by chemical bond. So first illustration I'm going to do here again is for a P wave, P seismic wave, which means a compressive wave, in which the motion is in the same direction as the wave. So we'll see what happens in this case. Okay. Notice that we have the same response. Okay? We have a solid, we have a liquid, and they both respond in the same way. In both cases, I'm able to send that compressive wave through the material. Okay, you can drop your arms. Now, it's important to realize that a compressive wave, not only can it travel through a solid, it can also travel through a liquid, and it can also travel through a gas. We call those sound waves. So a compressive wave can actually travel through any type of material, any state of matter, solid, liquid, or gas. It doesn't matter that a pressure wave or a compression wave, a P wave, will be able to travel through any kind of material. Now let's see if that's the same case with an S wave. Right? Now, again, line up like you did before, facing out with your arms out, but again, don't lock. Okay? So, same kind of situation here, but you're not locked. Okay? So, we're in the same position, we're still close together, right? So the atoms are still close together, but they're, again, not bound to each other, they're not chemically bound to each other. So now we want to see if we can send a shearing wave, that is a wave in which the motion is perpendicular to the direction that propagates through the material. Right? Everyone ready? Notice that I cannot send an S wave through the material. And that's because there's no chemical bonds. The only way that the energy can get transferred through an S wave is through those chemical bonds. If they're not present, you cannot send the energy through the material. So imagine if you're in a swimming pool or some body of water, right? You can send a compressive wave through that body of water. But if you try to send a shearing wave, like you want to send a wave that way, you can't do it by trying to push the water this way. It's not going to go that way. You can't propagate a wave, an S wave, through a liquid. So one of the important distinctions between a P wave and an S wave, P waves are compressional, and S waves are shearing waves. P waves can travel through any state of matter, but S waves can only travel through a solid in which the atoms are bound to each other. Okay, thanks.